Form file upload. In any form, you can upload a file. It's as simple as uploading a file. But how do you build it? Good question. Let's dig in. We'll cover adding file upload to your form, then we'll customize those upload settings. We'll go over customizing upload states. These are what people will see depending on how they're interacting with the form. And we'll end on managing file submissions. Let's start with adding file upload. First, you'll want to have a form. Next, you'll drag the form file upload thing right into that form. By default, it says upload file. Maybe you want to indicate that you expect people to upload a resume, which is, by the way, a word that has an acute accent over both E's. This version's acceptable, this one's great, and this one's completely butchered. In our case, we simply pasted in the term from a Google search, stealing, of course, from Wikipedia. Also, beyond the accent, we added even more content in our guide on Webflow University, so if you want to customize the button further, check that out. But that's the first part. Second part, upload settings. With any of the file upload elements selected, go to the element settings. Here, we see the states. We cover all four of these in the next section, but for now, let's move on to the name field. This will be what shows up on your form submission, so keep that in mind if you want to change it. Maybe people have been forgetting to submit their resume. Now they won't forget, because it's required. Maybe people have been sending in awkward audio clips, when in reality, you or your client just want a resume. You can restrict the uploads to just documents, or if you only want PDFs, you can type that in here. Maybe add GIFs so you can get that file type too. Next, we have our upload states. If these look familiar, it's because they've been on the screen this whole time. Four states. Default, which is what displays when someone sees the form without doing anything. Uploading is what they see once they've started uploading a file. And success is what they see when they've successfully uploaded a file. Any of these can be customized. And for the error state, let's say someone tries to upload a massive file. Failed state. Maybe we want to edit that text too. We can select the kind of failure and simply click to edit. Whatever we decide, it's possible to customize this state and all the others. Now, here's a good time to note. What if you want more than one upload button? What if you want 20? Good news, you can add up to 20. But we can cross states off our list. Finally, we have file submissions. This is pretty simple. Anyone who's on the list, they'll get an email. In that email, URLs to any of those files uploaded in that form. By default, you'll have to be logged in to access this. If you're the data controller of a project, you can also access and view submitted files for each project in Project Settings, Forms, Form Submission Data. Not here, all the way at the bottom. There's our upload. And what about your clients? They're good too. They can access this right from the editor, right under Forms. But that's it. We've covered a ton here, adding file upload, upload settings, upload states, and file submissions. Now you can build crazy forms and explore the galaxy. And that's form file upload in Webflow.